Force Iowa's Artful Connections. My name is John Fusco. For the next hour, we're going to be chipping away at a piece you might be familiar with. We're talking about process, a semi-instructional walkthrough of what I'm working on here. It's an imagined piece. I do have some references for it, but for the most part it's imagined, which has its own unique share of challenges and interests and those. We'll just make a little progress on that. I do invite you, as we do every week, to paint along, draw along with me, whatever you like, your own imagined work, perhaps. And then if you have been working on one of those too, share it at the end. Put it in the comments, we'd love to see. Now I'm just mixing up. Color, we're gonna make some big decisions here today. Just do a little reshaping of some of these faces, because some of them are bothering me. And I think they'll be all the stronger for it. In particular, this one at the bottom, which we ended up, I think, moving a bit. Today we'll be reshaping this guy at least. Maybe just the bottom few. Maybe we'll just kind of focus on these today and kind of solidify the sense of weight and space that we have here. It's absurd, but we can still make it look kind of natural. Just joining us. This is ArtFul, Iowa's ArtFul Connections. My name is John Fusco. Happy to have you. Please do paint or draw along with me, villain, or if you're just hanging out. Quite alright. But we do want to see what you're working on in the comments below. A little bit to the parts of the head that are mobile and parts that aren't. So what's the only joint in the skull? Well, it's the jaw. So we're going to want to sort of droop them down a little bit. Sort of like it's just sort of hanging. I don't know if anyone here is familiar with Jenny Seville. She's done some interesting work. One self-portrait in particular, which features, I think it is her face, but she's laying on her side, a little bit like this. And if you ever take that piece and turn it upright, it looks really strange just because of how much is drooping to that side. Doesn't, like, when you see it right side up, it doesn't look so weird. But if you kind of turn it up so that it's defying gravity, it looks really peculiar, but it really does draw attention to just how much of the face is soft and mobile. And I just want to make sure that I capture some of that here. We're not going to be doing quite so naturalistic as Jenny Seville, but I think that piece is a lesson in what's possible. Because this is a little dreamlike, I want this one to be a little bit stranger than that, and maybe not make as much sense, but I do kind of like that quality about her work. Kind of, just start with that. But yeah, that sort of, that really like fleshy quality in her work is what draws me to her anyway. So we'll see what we can do. Yeah, if you have any questions, I'll be peeking at the phone here every now and again and just making sure I'm not missing any. Otherwise, just sit back and we'll see how far we can get today. I was thinking about starting something new, but the truth is I'm a little bit buried as it is. So I figured I should probably just work on something I already have around, rather than adding one more thing to the to-do list. So hopefully you guys aren't sick of seeing this one. Alright, just mixing up the dark here. With, I could list all the colors. The truth is I'm making kind of a brown. It's got to be sort of everything in it. Brown is not a hard color to make. It's basically every color, and you can just sort of tilt it whatever direction you need it to, just to tilt, warm or cold or green or yellow. Alright. And I had, that's right, I had a reference here. Grab my reference. Because I think, yeah, actually, okay. That is what we want, but in a different place. So we're just going to switch that away. And we're going to make that same mark but down here. Like so. I just had a reference of somebody. I looked up somebody drooling, like, on their pillow. So that's what I'm basing this on. Because that's kind of the vibe we want, I think. And that is way too dark for that corner. Oof. Some mistakes to make. That's okay. Mistakes. We just, well, I guess we just have excellent today. Still gotta fix them. Yeah, so then the question is, so when I first did the sketch for this piece, I was looking at pictures of babies, because they had kind of scrunched up faces, and I have slowly deviated from that. I don't know if I'm going to be returning to it too much, but I might bring back some of that a little bit. We'll start with this though. Fits. All right. And I want this to do. A good rule of thumb with shadow, especially if you're going for kind of a more impressionist or just a more saturated approach to color, which I'm often guilty of exactly that. Just cooling things down considerably, and even going further than you might think you should. So, like, let's say I have this, like, bright orange color. Making a purple shadow will work better than you might think it would. If you added blue to orange, it'll just turn gray. You can do that, and that wouldn't look bad either, but if your goal is saturation, we don't necessarily want it to turn gray. So. How does that feel? I think that's. Ooh. I have a kitty cat who's a little bit perturbed today. She was meowing earlier too. She's very, very old. It can be a little hard to know what she wants. I tried to pay tribute and see what she wanted earlier, but I guess I didn't do good enough. So apologies for all the meowing. Her name is Ruby. She was born in 1999. She's okay. She's okay. For a cat born in 1999, she's okay. So as I'm shaping the head, among the things I'm thinking about, well, what I'm mostly thinking about, okay, so you can really break the head down into four planes. There's the front, you know, it is effectively, you don't want to think of it this way, but it is effectively a rectangle. You have your fronts, you have your side, and you have your back side. You know, we often see this line that usually starts somewhere in the middle of the eyebrow, which is where the side of the head technically will start. So what I'm working on right now is creating, just sort of establishing those planes. At the moment, all of these heads, at least a lot of them, some of them are actually more developed than others, but some of them are, largely just sketches. Like, it's more like a placeholder. Like, here's where the head will be. That's mostly what I have down. I just want to start making some big decisions and just finalizing at least one of them today. So yeah, typically that line would be like right there. Yeah, and it would follow along the cheekbone, something like that. And I'm gonna be cleaning that up as we go, but just kind of roughly where I think it's going to be. Just make a little more sense there. Oof, you know what? I need to grab a clean paper towel. Probably not the cleanest part of my process is how many paper towels I go through. You can use rags. Goodness knows I use quite a few of those too. Every so often, paper towels are just kind of handy. Especially, I've been trying this new thing where I'm trying not to have to use gloves because it's getting to be way too hot in here for gloves. So I'm just keeping the handles really clean. And one way to keep the handles clean is by protecting them from the rags below and paper towels. If the handles are clean, then you don't really have to wear gloves. But get that shadow core. Everybody remembers their anatomy of a shadow. Your mid-tone, your shadow core, and your reflected light. And then there, I think there's just another part. It's just like the shadow core. Not the shadow core, but like the rest of the shadow. I don't remember what that's called. It might just be called shadow. But at any rate, you want all of them. While we have the color on the brush, we're just going to drag it and put it through some of the other shapes. I don't do very many magic works anymore, so I find it goes pretty slow. But it really frees you up to get weird. But I would also just remind you that it's okay to take your time. It really is. Not in any hurry. And the more you do something, the faster it goes, of course. But I typically find if I'm getting impatient with these things, time to move on to something else for a little while and come back to it later. Because as soon as you get impatient, you start making bad decisions. Just as we should be patient with ourselves when we're having a tough day, we should be patient with our paintings when they're giving us some trouble. And just leave it, come back later. And actually, my hands are shaking this morning, so let's see if we can't do this. I have my mall stick, but it's not really long enough for this. I need to actually make some adjustments on it. Because if you can create a nubbin at the end, then you can kind of place it on the work. I think you use cheesecloth. And I don't know if it's like a tennis ball or some other sort of small ball, maybe a ping pong ball, at the end of the stick. Then you can kind of place it on the piece itself, and it won't smear. And it should hold pretty well. But I haven't done that yet. This piece is so tall. I'm going to want to. Cool. All right. Slowly and surely. Let's actually get the highlight color mixed up too. While we're at it. So I want one. I'm working on another piece that actually I would prefer to be working on today, but it's a commission, which. And the client is not who it's for. So on the off chance they would see it, since this is the internet, and I don't actually know how many people watch these. But you never know. Somebody might see it who knows the person and be like, hey, I saw your face. And they'll know they're getting a painting. So I can't work on it today, but luckily this one actually uses a few of the same colors. These pinks and oranges are making an appearance in that piece. So, works out pretty good. Also, that piece is not photographing well. Just the colors are getting really weird, and the camera does not know how to display it. Highlight color, and then I just made a different shape. So we're gonna get some cadmium lemon, because cadmium lemon is just fantastic for highlights. I'm gonna see what zinc white does. We might break out the flake or the titanium. Just see what zinc does. Zinc being more transparent, titanium being far more opaque. Zinc is good when you're trying to preserve color. Titanium is good when you really need some really sharp highlights. Flake white, I'm still trying to figure out flake white. I'm told flake white is often used in skin tones. I think it's supposed to be translucent. It's also quite gummy. So it has kind of a different texture than I haven't fully... Like, I've used it just to use it, but I haven't fully discovered what makes flake white special. Highlight, and I think that needs to come right here, because the whole time I'm thinking about light direction. Every time I'm building up light, I keep in mind, where's my light? My light's somewhere up here. It's coming down at a slight angle. I think it's kind of in front of them, them being the heads. So just want to kind of drag it along here, something like that, and which means it'll probably catch right here as well. Although, as it curves away, but again, we have kind of a plane here. It's not gonna start curving until right around here. So this whole area should light up a little bit, at least a little bit. Just gonna clean another brush here, because yeah, I've been working on other stuff, so I have, all my brushes are dirty. Have too many brushes going. There's nothing wrong with having too many brushes going. I just get a little flustered, and then it's a lot more cleanup at the end. Cleaning oil brushes is a very, very important step, but it can be a little time consuming. But take care of your brushes, and they'll take care of you. I do wish I had like a camera too on my palette so you guys could watch that part. But if I only had the camera lingering on the palette and not on the piece, then every time I was painting, you would be seeing what I'm doing. So I think the piece is what the camera needs to be on. But if I had my druthers, we'd have both. If you're just joining us, this is ArtFul. My name is ArtFul Connections. My name is John Fusco, and today we're doing an imagined piece. That's kind of a long haul project, but we're going to chip away at it today. Make some big decisions in shaping this bottom head. I think that doing the bottom head is going to be worthwhile, because if I can kind of build all this up and kind of create this nice solid sense of space, then as we go up, I have like something solid to lean it all on. Also, since the heads all overlap, the top head always overlapping the bottom one a little bit, it'll just work better to work in this order as well. So, but The way the paint will layer will make more sense. So we'll just go run with that. And that is the color. Cool. Okay, so. Making noses and lips red. When in doubt, kind of tinting them red.
This kind of thing. Why? Well, I don't actually tell you exactly why. I just like it.
It makes for a really nice, easily identifiable section of the face. A certain cartoonish quality, which you may or may not want, but I kind of want it. And it just feels right more often than it doesn't for me. And since these heads are all going to be kind of, my goal in the end is just to feel a little bit like jelly.
Having extra red noses would make a lot of visual sense.
As for noses, I mean, noses are hard, gang. They are. Without a reference, yeah, it would be hard to make a really compelling, realistic-looking nose. I'm basing this nose right now on not a great deal. I will be coming back armed with some other references to solidify, in particular the bottom part, but I'll have most of the ridge figured out. And the ridge is simple enough as a front face and then those two side faces which slope down. And those slopes I think this might even come up a little higher. Yeah, those slopes will just transition into the cheek. And then you just have your front plate here. Like so. Here's a brush I'm always trying to use more because I know that there's a lot of cool things you can do with the fan brush. But I just don't use it that often. But I know some artists I follow who use it to great effect. So there's something to be said for working in the fan brush because it does have all this. Oh, there's the kitty cat again. Usually it means she found a sock. It's weird though, because she doesn't seem to want to. Like if I go to her right now, there's a good chance she'll run away. Like she'll meow as though she's announcing, "Hey, I got this sock." So you go and you see her. To go help her celebrate that she found the sock, and she doesn't seem to want to talk about it. She'll just kind of brush off. I don't fully understand what the meowing is. When you Google it, you know, you typically find like a list of like 30 items that it could be that they're trying to accomplish by meowing, and so I don't really know. I don't know. What I gathered from it is that it's hard to be old. And I think that that's about all you can say about that.
if you just joined us, that was my cat Rudy. 21 years young, her birthday was in February. I think this is dry, let me mess my hand here. She's mostly been good for these videos, but she doesn't have it behind. She normally does it at night. You know, when you're trying to sleep. You know what? I think I'm gonna... Easels are cool, but they're not always ideal for working large. I know some folks will just set pieces on, like, paint cans and elevate them, like, 1 foot off of the floor. And you just kind of work on the floor. And now that I have this color, I'm just kind of taking it and working on some other faces. Cause I'm feeling a break coming on this bottom head. Situation to feel like, and I'm not really there yet. Not quite there yet. So I'm just gonna push that up a bit. And move on. I'm gonna do something else for a little bit. Go to the next head up, and start working on this guy. I actually really like a lot of these shapes, and this nose shadow is working for me. I think we're just going to keep playing with that. And yeah, this would be an example of where we have the four planes. Now, I don't think I have the plane in quite the right place here. I think I need to move it over a hair. Like so, but yeah, where you have like the four planes of the face, to some extent we have that pretty well laid out right here. And I want to kind of lay off right here because the lip is going to flank out. It's going to be like a shelf. It's going to come out. It's going to catch that light. So I'm not gonna darken that, but I wanna bring this shadow down a hair. Not a hair, I guess all the way down. But with mindfulness to the topography of the face. We'll come back to the other face. I'm realizing that I'm going to need to adjust all of this at the bottom to make that work and to move the easel, and I don't really want to wrestle with the easel on camera because it's a little bit janky. And my preference would be that these videos are relaxing. A bunch of sleepy heads. That's what we got here. Okay. So. And just while I have this color ready, I'm just curious what happens if that's a shadow.
Well, not on head. He looked a little pursed. A little more pursed than I want.
Just makes it look kind of a warm, very warm purple. That's what I'm aiming for right now. Using Kanakradon Magenta, Light Magenta, Ultramarine, and a little bit. Well, I was thinking about using Sink White, but I think that the Light Magenta is going to be good enough. Because I don't want to go too dark. The hope with this piece is that everything stays fairly well lit. I don't want a lot of hard shadows. That's just like a preference of atmosphere.
It is a lot darker than I thought it would be.
Yeah, so we are going to throw some zinc in there. And again, I use zinc because it'll lighten it without, like, just killing it. Without it getting so bright that it's washed out. That's more like it, yeah. That's more like it. That's what we want. Yeah, something like that. Cool. Alright.
And then bring it in right here. And
yeah. The lighting faces from underneath is a little bit tricky. That as we go, and just kind of seeing what feels good. But as I'm doing that, same basic rules are going through my head. I'm just trying to think about where, you know, like where the face comes in, where it pops back out, where it goes back in, and if my light's coming down, where does it catch? For instance, I think it would catch a little more right here. Oof, that is oily. You can fix that. So you can just take a little paper towel and do a zip like that. This one is funny. We are going to want to actually do some sketching here in a little bit. Because I'm realizing how little scaffolding I have on that head. And I just like, do not have a lot to work with. This one's pretty well like established. I have a pretty good idea of where everything is at. A little bit of scaffolding, just a little more to work with in terms of knowing where to fit my marks. And I'm just doing this to outline where I'm going to have a tonal shift, basically where the head's going to curve away and become a little bit darker. Do the same thing up here. I like sketching in red because I like having that red come through later. A little bit. But you can really sketch in any color. Keeping it warm is nice for keeping your paintings warm. There are plenty of people who sketch in brown. I don't know anyone. I haven't seen a lot of underpaintings in blue, but I'm sure it can be done. I think that there's a tendency for people to want their work to be warm, though. But yeah, we are going to want to figure something out with this head. So let's just kind of carve some stuff out.
carving out here, mostly, just the planes of the face, just like broad stroke, like shifts in the topography of the face. So, get that front plate in. You know, it's not going to be perfect. Again, I want them to feel kind of jelly-like and floppy. But I also want them to make some sense. Yeah. Something like that. But then down here, I'm trying to decide. I just think it'll help a lot to have some kind of plan. It's black line. Okay, so let's try working within some of that. So what I was doing here, I'm doing a terrible job of narrating, was I just trying to think about all my planes and where they need to be. I think that actually came down a little too low. And having a paper towel handy for wiping, especially with oil paint, since it won't dry, pretty useful. So just so you don't get confused. I think we're gonna give this guy laugh lines. What do you think? I think so. I say guy. I don't think these things have a gender. I certainly don't think they need one. Yeah, a little more of a plan, which is nice. Definitely want a little more of a plan. I have before. Yeah, especially with these heads being lifted from underneath, it just feels like it's going to make things a lot easier. And while we've got our sketching pen out, who else needs a little bit more work? This one does not make sense to me right now, so we're going to pull him down a hair. Down. We won't have any hair. Floppy chin on this one. Nice. Yeah, that's what we want. Okay. And I rather like this face, but I don't think that doesn't mean we can't make some adjustments. Just bring that down. Not a lot, just like a little bit closer. And then clean up that edge, because this is kind of a jumbled mess. Exactly where it begins and ends is not as clear as I'd like it to be. He's underlit. I want to have some planes of the face marked out, just so the lighting is easier. And while we've got it out, let's go ahead and address the head. I said I was going to try and focus on today until I realized that I need to think about it more. Let's think about it now. Leaving room for mistakes, because if you make a mark that like just does not make sense, that's okay. I'm working from imagination, which means sometimes it's gonna make sense and sometimes it won't. I don't like that mark very much, so I'm gonna get rid of that. Maybe it goes this way. Something like that, but then I think we're gonna have a laugh line. As well, and the question is how close it needs to be. I think that comes out a little bit more the way. So, I mean, this is gonna be tedious, but process. Make things easier down the way. Yeah, if I had my druthers, I think I would have done this last night. But I still have some deadlines. Coming up. And so this will just be a little less exciting day of process as this is something comes out. Kind of figuring things out day. Strangely enough, that kind of flew by. This is a slow piece. Thank you for joining me today on this slow-paced journey. Appreciate it. I won't be here next week, or for a few weeks, but when I do come back, we'll have something new started. Shadow. Cut through here. I'm just going to make kind of a map for my shadow. Cuts through here. Probably even joins the ground. Cool. Actually, on this head, I just want to see what happens if we just start making those shadows happen. Yeah, I think that's good. We'll need to do reflected light. The reflected light's going to help a lot with that. Otherwise, it looks a little flat. But that is. That is at the very least, the color and the vibe that I want. This has been a tough morning to be an old cat. I don't know how much of that the mic is picking up, but I think it's a tough morning to be an old cat, and that's what I'm gathering today. Let's bring out some highlight vibes. So, mixing up got my cadmium lemon, got some handsome yellow, which is what sounds to me like handsome yellow. It is a handsome yellow. Some brilliant pink. Really yellow that up though. And some titanium. Positively glowing. Cool. So, where do we put these? I'm just going to be kind of dashing along. I think also. There, which also means they might catch this lip down here, her forehead right here. As we build up our layers, some of these red lines are going to go away. And I got a thing too. It looks a little like he's been injured. So, don't want that. And yeah, like, so in the end, it'll look a little more like how we have her face here, where it's sort of blended together. something with like her, we're gonna probably come through and clean up some of the red lines. They're mostly just there to help do this part and give me something to trace. Start building up kind of a glowing edge. Eventually we'll go through and we'll do the apples, but apples aren't that hard. I kind of like to do the hard stuff first. These faces are hard. Yes, they are. They really are. Portraits are hard. Making up heads is hard. But the possibilities. You can do it. Yes, you can. Practice and perfection. All hand in hand. If there's such a thing as perfect. I bet you can do it. So just doing a little bit of exciting stuff here at the end. Got quite a bit of good planning done. This time around. I think I'm largely out of time. So I'm gonna make a few more marks here. And then we're just going to leave this the mess that it is, and I'll clean it up off camera. But just want you to know how much I appreciate you guys spending your Monday with me, or whatever day you're watching this. And whatever day you're watching this, if you painted along with me, we really do. It's not a joke. We really want to see what you're working on. Please do share it. This has been ArtForce Iowa. ArtForce. Iowa's ArtFul Connections. And my name is Jonathan Fusco. And I think that's a wrap. And I'll return to this another day, probably off camera. Thank you so much for joining me. Happy Monday.